On Sunday afternoon at 12 noon, we have the Agape Vespers. And this is a Vesper service, very, very special. It is a proclamation in all the languages of the resurrection. We're blessed at Holy Cross to have many people who speak various languages. We had probably at least a dozen languages that we proclaimed the gospel in.
La pace sia con voi. Poi mostrò agli discepoli le mani e il fianco.
Y cuando les hubo dicho esto, les mostró las manos y el costado.
Pridi Jesús ista posredie y glagolia im mir vam y sirec pokaze im rustie y nosi rebia svoja.
Bonus en edicta sonora on la rave in ebe per un unico stetito.
A stat în mijlocul lor și le-a zis, pace vouă. Și după ce a zis aceste vorbe, le-a arătat mâinile și coasta sa.
Il feno Iisus, che estiendo meson, che lei aftis.
Avenos discipulos, com merdos judeus, veios Iisus, posse numeo ediselies.
Il cranie le juif, Jésus vient et se tient au milieu d'eux et leur dit la paix avec soi avec vous.
И говорит им: мир вам. Сказав это, он показал им руки и ноги и ребра свои.
Propter me tum iadorum. When Jesus stati in medio.
The gospel is about Thomas. Thomas, who is not present when the Christ first makes his appearance, is the gospel from John. Christ appears to the 11, he breathes on them and says, receive the Holy Spirit. The sins of those you forgive, they are forgiven. The sins that you retain, they are retained, reminding us of the importance of holy confession. And then Christ shows them his hands and his side, and then he leaves. And Thomas comes and he says, unless I see in the mark of the nails and put my hands in his side, I will not believe. And of course, then this sets up the stage for the following Sunday, the Sunday of Thomas, where he then sees Christ. Christ comes and appears, and he is present, and he bears witness, my Lord and my God. And he understands that Jesus is the Son of God, risen from the dead, trampling down death by death, and that those in the tombs bestowing life. The church emphasizes on the first 2 weeks after Pascha, the eyewitnesses of those who were with Christ after the resurrection, who were with him, who experienced his teachings, that in our time of doubt, that we should remember Thomas. Our faith is constantly being challenged because we don't see the risen Lord, but we know from the testimony of the gospel that we do experience him, and we experience him in the life of the sacraments. We have accounts of the 12, the 70, and the Acts of the Apostle of the 500 whom Christ appeared to, the risen Lord appeared to. So we have these eyewitnesses that we know the gospel testimony is true, and that the risen Lord is very much the foundation of our faith. Even though we may have doubts in our lives, we should remember that we have more proof of the resurrection of Christ than we do of most things in historical facts. So this is something to remind ourselves of and to take courage from. We know this is true because it changed the disciples who were fishermen and who were afraid and who left Jesus when he was being crucified, and they became warriors for Christ. And all of them died a martyr's death, with the exception of St. John the Evangelist. The resurrection transformed them into witnesses of Christ, into witnesses that we are called to be in this world. Christ is risen.